Okay, this is Sophie here. We worked with her a couple times before. The owner says she's scared of plastic bags. So what I got here is this. I just tied a couple grocery bags onto an old whip that somebody threw away. I guess it wasn't hurting the horse enough. They wanted a stiffer one or something. Anyway, so I tied a couple plastic bags to this, and I'm wiggling around. And you watch this horse. She's pretty nervous about this. And what a lot of people want to do with plastic bags is they want to get the horse and put it in their stall. Well, I tied plastic bags around my horse's stall, and that way I'm tired of it being scared of play. You're teaching your horse to deal with his fear without you. You're teaching a horse that plastic bags in his stall may not hurt him. You're teaching him to be scared in his stall. Of course, Buddy's going to come over and mess up the program here. This horse probably kicked the crap out of him. Because she's scared and he ain't. So, look at this horse's reaction here. So, what a lot of people want to do with this bag is they want to start trying to force it on a horse. Let me show it to you. Let me stick it in your face. I don't want to do that. This horse is scared of this plastic bag. So, what I want to do is I don't want to make the plastic bag the issue. This is the same thing people do with trailers. Horse don't want to go on a trailer. By God. Buddy, what are you doing? Walking behind me getting... going to get this horse fired up. So... And again, this is, I've got a camera in my hand, I've got a lead rope that I've got to control this horse that's going to pull and has already tried to pull. I walked around a little bit to get most of the freshness out of her. I got another horse running around free that can mess up my program. So ideally, am I setting this up for total success? No. If I'm going to do this, I should be doing it in a round pen or in a small area to where the horse can't get away and get its own release. I don't want this horse to be able to run away and break free. If this horse gets away from me, I undo everything I did. And I'll get a letter. I was working with my horse and it was doing great, and I tried to get in a trailer and I tried to shut the door really quick, and his back leg got caught in the door because he tried to get out, and now his back leg's hurt and he's scared of the back door. Well, no shit. You shouldn't try to slam him in the door and catch him. Everything that we do to horses, we set them up to either fail or success. So right now, I'm kind of taking advantage because I've done this a few times and that I think I can handle this. But if I screw up, the horse suffers. And I know I can fix it. I know I can undo whatever I do. That's not the issue. The issue is I'm trying to help this horse, and I want to help this horse succeed and grow as best I can. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to put this passive bag between me and her, and we're going to walk off. And I'm going to get this horse used to following me. So she doesn't want to. But she's going to learn that I got to follow him even though I'm scared of this plastic bag. Even though I'm snorting. And I'm not going to make this plastic bag the issue. Guess what? We're just leading. You're just walking with me. And this plastic bag happens to be blowing. And if you want to get close, well, you come on in and get close. And if you don't want to get close, well, then you don't get close. Now, what you don't want to do is say, shove this bag and make this horse run. Come on, you want the bag? And make her scared. Now she's doing a lot better. See how that bag went? Look at her. Look at her head. Look at that tail. This is reading a horse. This is learning how your horse reacts to fear. Those ears, those nose, man, she's breathing. She's blowing out. She's really got those nostrils expanded. Those are all instinctual things. Those nostrils are expanding so she can get oxygen, so she can run, so she can get blood to those big major muscles. And she can either kick and fight, or she can flight and use those muscles to haul butt. And that's what horses do. And I don't want to get this horse so excited. Has her nose, see her nose kind of shrunk down a little bit. She calmed down. Her head dropped a little bit because I kind of ignored it. And if I start making this bag the issue and going, come on, you quit being so scared and getting, look at those nose, look at that head, look at that body. Tense, scared, nervous. See, I'm reading this horse and her body language going up and down. And that's what sacking out is. That's reading your horse. That's understanding how your horse deals with fear and what he does. So you will understand when you're on him and he starts getting anxious or nervous, you'll figure out, hey, you know what? I better pay attention. I better give this horse a little more direction. I better start focusing on his horse because he's getting scared about something. And I don't know what it is. Now, of course, if you're trying to get him to go over a creek between a down tree and he's nervous, or you run across a dead animal and he starts snorting and nervous and you're trying to work through it, well, you can still read it, but you'll know what's going to happen right before it happens. And that's the key. You don't want to push this horse to where it blows up. This horse, if you notice, the nostrils have gotten a little bit smaller. There they go again. Okay, did you hear me talking about your nose? Is that you're gonna get them? So look at those ears. They're getting a little more relaxed because they're not so focused. The tail's getting a little bit calmer. Look at the head. If a horse eats, they're not that stinking nervous. Because a horse will not eat if they're that nervous about getting eaten. They're not going to lower their head when they're in a threatening situation. That's against all their instincts. So the fact that she's going to lower her head and eat tells me she's getting a little more use of this plastic bag. You saw that little paw there. I think that was a fly versus aggressiveness. But these are things that this horse just needs to do. Now somebody's going to want to come out here and want to sack this horse out and tie it to a hitching post and just throw sacks over it and shove shit on it and scare the crap out of the horse and say, you know what, that horse just needs to be shown who's boss. No, he doesn't. The horse needs to know that it's okay to be scared. I just can't run off when I'm scared. It's okay to be nervous around something, but I still got to pay attention to the guy holding his lead rope. Right now, this horse instinct is, I want out of here. If I didn't have this horse on this rope, it'd be gone. And it damn sure wouldn't be following me. So I'm going to give it a little pressure and see if I can get it to come against where it wants to go. See if my pressure is more than this bag. Who's creating more pressure? I am. Look at that. Look at that. I gave her just enough. Good girl. I just barely took the slack out of that rope and she said, okay, I'll come in. Which tells me she's responding to my pressure and my direction more than her instinctual fear of this bag. That's sacking out. That's understanding a horse. And, you know, you get these people who want to just tie the bags around there and put 50 cones in their stall. And every time a horse scares something, well, I'll just throw it in the damn stall and I'll make the horse sleep with it. Well, that's just mean, you know. I mean, if a kid's scared of the dark, you don't just lock them in a dark room and make scary noise and expect the kid to get over it. You work through it. You help him. You show him that it's okay and you try to, you know, work through those fears. And this horse's head is telling me that she's kind of dealing with this fear better. Her head has dropped now that I'm sitting here talking. And all this is time. Time and exposure. Watch me, I'm gonna take the slack out of this lead rope. And this is where feel comes in. I could pull this horse. See, she just took the slack out of lead rope. Lead rope's tight now. I can feel her pulling on me just a little bit. Now if I pull back and we get in a fight, but she's eating, you know what that's telling me? I'm not paying attention. You are the bag. You are the bag, really ain't that important. So I'm gonna take the slack out of this rope, go, hey. Come with me. Come. See, we can't get that. Look at that. See, I'm keeping slacking the lead rope, and I'm getting her to follow me. I'm getting her to come to her fear. Look at that. Head's dropping. She's going to go, I'm going to go get a train. Hey, that's pretty good. You know what? If you want to eat while I'm sacking you out, perfect. That means that you're not scared of the bag. That means that you're dealing with your fear better than running off, rearing, and being crazy. And that's what I want, you know? Too many people want to have control of their horse and focus so much on what they're scared of and want to show them who's boss and want to have that control that they forget that the horse is just being a horse. And that's all it knows how to be. And I'm telling you, this horse, when I first pulled this plastic bag out and it was tied out, I got it on my truck. Man, let me tell you, this horse was like, dude, if you come over here, me and you are going to dance and you ain't going to like it. And so what I did is I ignored her. I brought the plastic bag over to Buddy and I rubbed it on Buddy. I brought it over to Tanner. I rubbed it on Tanner. And I let her see that it didn't eat or kill these other two horses. And she watched that. And she learned from watching. That's why I tell people, you know, when you got a spooky horse, people want to go out. Oh, your horse is spooky? Mine is too. Let's go out for a ride together. Oh, my God. I just want to go, what are you guys thinking? You don't want a spooky horse going out with a spooky horse. They just feed on each other. You want a horse going out with a confident horse. I don't want a horse that's in a hurry back to the barn to go out with another horse that's in a hurry back to the barn. They'll be racing and fighting us all the way back to the barn and we'll be losing. And we'll be increasing their fear and control by putting another horse doing the same thing. So they think, you know what, if the other horse does it, well then I have to do it. When one horse runs, a horse doesn't go, wonder why those horses are running. They run because they want to stay alive. And that's what they do. And that's their herd instinct. So when one horse runs, another horse runs with them, that's instinctual. They're not being mean. They're not being scared, stupid, or flighty. They're being a horse. And that's all they know how to be. So understanding these guys, come on, let's walk a little bit. So basically all I'm going to do is walk this horse around with this plastic bag. You know what? My goal here is to make this plastic bag part of me and this horse, me and her. When we go out walking and I let you graze, guess what? I got a plastic bag with me. She's going to get over this plastic bag on her own. I don't have to teach her. I don't have to make her. All I have to do is expose her and let her know it's not going to hurt her. And sooner or later, she's going to be, you know what? I wonder if that plastic bag's higher than me. I wonder if that plastic bag's going to eat me. You didn't hear me yet. Let me go over and sniff it. Let me go over and bite it. You know, if I want to nibble on it to make sure it's not going to bite me back, let me do that. That's how you get a horse. Now, you know, I don't want to get over here. I could probably go rub this horse in this plastic bag right now, but holding this phone and holding the lead rope, I increase the chance of failing, and I don't want this horse to fail. So although I'd like to show you that it could be done and it's possible, I'm not going to do it because this is more for the horse. And I'm just hoping that people can learn from these horses and kind of learn from other horse problems and people problems. So I hope that helps on sacking out a horse scared of plastic bags. And, of course, don't forget, feed the horse and carrots and treats from a plastic bag. That'll help also. Okay, I had 10 minutes. Got to go.